What's up, Shredheads? Shiny Fates season is upon us, and that means we are opening Shiny Fates on the channel today that I've got right. So Shreddy has zero credits to open, but what we're going to cover in today's video is we're going to turn that zero, we're going to put one in front of it, and a zero, as Shreddy counts down the top 10 most expensive pulls from Shining Fates as of the release date. So when you're opening your Shiny Fates packs, keep an eye out for these top 10 cards. You might want to go and grab an ice pack because we're about to have some heat in this video.
Are you ready for Shreddy?
This is the most scalped set that I have ever seen in Pokemon cards, and I'm already seeing Facebook groups literally spammed with people selling for well over double the prices of RRP. I'm not surprised, because Shining Fates, since it was announced, has said to have been super popular. I'll be making a video explaining why I think, from a long-term investment point of view, that Shining Fates just won't match Hidden Fates. And I could be completely wrong with that, but if you would like to hear my thoughts as to why I think that, then please do let me know down below. So what we're going to do today is count down the top 10 most expensive cards to pull. All of the prices in today's video have came from tcgplayer.com. If you're looking to buy individual cards, this is probably not the time to be buying them. What we typically see when a new set releases is the big chase cards sell for super high prices. Within less than a week, the price dropped significantly. I would personally hold off for a couple of weeks before buying them, otherwise you're going to be paying top dollar. For those who are lucky enough to have packs to open and to get the mega chase cards, then it's a race to basically get them off, to get them graded as quickly as possible, to get them back, to be the first to market to sell these cards, to be able to sell them for the most money. But with those disclaimers out of the way, let's take a look at card number 10. So first up on this list is the gold card Eternatus card, and that is being priced at around $40 at the minute. Eternatus is one of those Pokemon that kind of doesn't really seem hugely popular, but it's a card that I personally like. One of the legendaries from Sword and Shield. It's an interesting design is probably the best way that I would put it. And there's actually more than one Eternatus card in this set, but it's the regular Eternatus gold card that is coming in at the 10th spot on today's video, priced at around $40.
Number 9, ooh yeah.
So coming in at number 9, we're kicking it all the way old school as we go back to Johto, back to a time when legendaries still meant something, and we're looking at one of the three legendary dogs, Suicune, also the poster child of Pokemon Crystal. Coming in at the number 9 spot and running around $43 for the raw card is Suicune. The art on this card is very nice, and I always like it when we see Pokemon cards that don't have to be a Pokemon V card or a full art card for them to look cool and for them to have value. It's nice to see regular cards kind of maintaining that value a little bit, and that Suicune is a good example of this. And it's actually something that we see in the Shiny Vault quite a little bit, as in it's not always the full art cards that are always the most valuable ones. But good to see that the Suicune card in this is one of the more sought after cards, and good to see it's got some value there. Number 8! Forget Alex the Kid from all the way back in the Sega days, we have got the Pokey Kid coming in at around $44 for this card. Now this card is a full art trainer card, and full art trainer cards over the past, you know, however many years of Pokemon, always look very, very nice. This Pokey Kid in the Eevee cosplay, the second most expensive trainer card in the set as of release. And you know, when you're comparing trainers to modern trainers to vintage trainers, back then nobody cared for trainers, but it's, you know, in this modern era that we're in, some of the full art trainer cards are some of the best art that we get in Pokemon. And this is the first of two trainer cards in the top 10 list in today's video. What do you think the other trainer card's gonna be? Well, let me know down in the comments below. Number 7. Coming in just above Pokey Kid at $45, we have Grimmsnarl. This dark fairy type Pokemon is actually one of my favorite Pokemon from the modern generation. And don't get me wrong, I can't really relate, I can't really remember a lot of the names of modern Pokemon off the top of my head. But playing through Sword and Shield, Grimmsnarl was one of those Pokemon I looked at and thought, beast. Shiny Bolt version of Grimmsnarl in the set looks like a very sick card. And at the time of making this video, the release weekend of Shine and Fate, it's going to run you $45. Sick art, full art, cool, menacing looking Pokemon. Probably it's a card that I would like to add to my own collection.
Number 6.
My Little Pony has all grown up as we have got the Galarian Rapidash coming in just above Grimmsnarl at just over $45. Now, for the purpose of this video, these cards were broken down into dollars and cents on TCG Player. I've just rounded it off to the nearest dollar, but the Rapidash came in slightly more expensive than the Grimmsnarl. I'm a big fan of the regional specific Pokemon. It's cool to see those older Pokemon, for me particularly, the Gen 1 Pokemon, get a new lease of life or to get, you know, a new skin, get a bit more story on them from these different regions. But we've got this Rapidash coming in the number 6 spot. In the words of Booker T, five time. We ain't got the WCW champion. We have got Ditto, shiny Ditto VMAX coming in at $57. And this is probably one of the most popular Pokemon coming out of Shiny Star V. I was lucky enough to pull this in one of my Shiny Star V openings. That's on the channel if you want to go and check that out. I'll link to it down below and at the end of this video. Shiny Ditto got a lot of love in Shiny Star V, making this one of the most desirable cards of the set.
Number 4. Dig it!
So the only Pokemon to appear on this list twice today is the returning Eternatus, but this time it's the Eternatus VMAX gold cards, and this is running around $63. It's the VMAX version of the card we've already seen, and I don't really have much more to say about it than that. But what do you guys think? Let's already know down below. Numero 3. In a very similar position to what Ditto has found itself in, we've got the shiny VMAX Lapras, which is always going to be a popular card, a popular Pokemon, one of the favorites from Shiny Star V. And this version of Lapras is running around $73 at the time of filming. Again, this is one of the cards that I was able to pull from one of my Shiny Star V boxes. It's one of those timeless Pokemon dating all the way back to Gen 1. Very popular Pokemon and one of the most desirable cards of the set. Whether you've pulled one in Japanese or in English, let us already know down below.
Number 2.
This is the second full art trainer to be making its way onto the list and is the second most expensive card in the set, and that honor goes to Skylar, the gym leader from all the way back to Black and White. Now, Shreddy ain't gonna lie, when I saw this card, I was thinking to myself, who's Skylar? As I say all the time on this channel, guys, anything past Gen 2 for me, I'm not saying I'm not a fan of it, it's just, it's very hard. For I've got so much of my limited brain capacity taken up by Gen 1 and Gen 2, it's hard to cram all this extra Pokemon stuff into my brain. I had to do a Google search of Skylar. When I saw it, when I said Black and White, it was just one of those light bulb moments. Ah, I remember. But these trainer cards at the minute, over the past, what, I'd say 5, maybe 6 weeks, have absolutely been booming in price, especially in Japan. I honestly don't really know what has caused the spike in price for full art trainers. If somebody's, you know, a bit more clued up, please do let me know down below if somebody knows why these cards have been spiking in price. But the full art trainer cards, when I was opening up Hidden Fates, the Giovanni and the Team Rocket Jesse and James cards were two of the cards I was most wanting to pull. They're not that rare, they're not very expensive, but they just look like sick, you know, the really cool art. And again, this art here of Skylar, it's a really cool looking card. $91 is what this card is running at the time of making this video.
Number 1.
As surprising as the sky is blue and water is wet, we have the license to print money for the Pokemon Company in at the number 1 spot, which of course is the Charizard card, the shiny VMAX Charizard card, costing $612 at the time of recording. Everyone knew this was going to be the card to chase. Everyone knew this was going to be the most expensive card of the set. Why? Because Charizard. It'll be interesting to see how the price of this compares to the Hidden Fates shiny regular Charizards and to see what longevity that the VMAX versions of Pokemon have compared to the regular versions of Pokemon. But I think VMAX Pokemon have been handled pretty well within Sword and Shield. I think VMAX on some of these cards, VMAX designs in the games look pretty cool, especially the Gigantamax versions of these cards. Seeing them as the VMAX versions on these cards in this set, the Charizard does look pretty cool. We first saw this art announced for the Darkness of Blaze set, or was it the Rainbow promo? I can't quite remember which came first. Was it the chicken or was it the egg? Off the top of my head, surely can't remember. But we've finally seen the shiny version of this card in the set. If you're busting to get your hands on this, my advice, honestly, would be not to buy it straight out of the gate. I'm very confident that this price will drop probably in the next, definitely within the next month or so. Supply is very short at the minute, but as we see more product hitting retail, as we see more people opening these cards and we see more being pulled, the price is going to drop a little bit over the next couple of weeks. So be patient. Don't pay the scalpers prices for sealed products. And maybe just wait for that price on the Charizard to establish a little bit if you're patient enough. But there are the 10 most expensive cards to be looking out for in Shining Fates. Have you pulled any from this list yet? If you have, let me know down below. And what are you thinking of the set so far compared to Hidden Fates? Please do let me know if you would like to see me do that video about why I don't think Shining Fates is going to be as popular or have the longevity as what Hidden Fates did, especially for investing. I'm interested to hear what all of you guys think. We are well on the road to 8k subscribers now as well, guys. We're only a couple hundred away. So please, if you've enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up button. It pushes this video out to more Pokemon fans out there. If it's your first time watching this video today, then please do hit the subscribe button to see all of my Pokemon Card Classic videos on the channel, from opening videos to how to make money with Pokemon videos and retrospective videos. Pretty much just the ramblings of a jacked, stacked, lifelong Pokemon nerd. On screen now is a playlist of some of my other videos. If you've enjoyed this, then you'll be sure to enjoy those videos, so go and check it out. And until next time, remember that collecting ain't no gimmick, it's a lifestyle.